I'm Raghavan. I hail from the insurance and reinsurance industry. I used to be in the board level, in the general manager position in General Insurance Corporation of India, which is now called as GIC Re. I also was on secondment to the Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, which is IRDA, to set up what is called as the Insurance Information Bureau of India in Hyderabad, which is an analytics organization. And last, I was the part of the founding team as Chief Operating Officer of a private sector reinsurance company called as ITI Reinsurance Private Limited. This is my background. See, we have hospitals in various segments in the healthcare industry in India. One is obviously the government-run hospitals, both at the primary level, healthcare level. Then you have secondary level at district headquarters hospitals. And thirdly, you have specialist hospitals like AIIMS and, you know, AIIMS, etc. Secondly, you have a corporate-run kind of a chain of hospitals like Apollo Indraprastha. You also have, you know, medium-sized hospitals like, for example, the Gangaram Hospital in Delhi. You have also super specialty hospitals in India like, you know, the cancer institutes, TB institutes, etc. Now, no one has an exact number on number of hospitals in the country, basically because the regulatory system or infrastructure framework for hospital approval and establishment is scattered between the central government and the various state governments. Each state government has their own law, because the health is still a concurrent subject. With the result, what happens is there is no single database from where you can locate with all authenticity and genuineness as to which hospital is located in which place and who has approved its operations. So this leads to not only confusion in the minds of the general patient public, those who seek healthcare, but when it comes to the back office requirements like analytics or even control of certain diseases like endemics and epidemics, it leads to a huge yawning gap. And therefore, the lack of a single national health registry of hospitals on their own is a huge deterrent to analytics in the country. Add to this the problem of the health insurance companies. They require basically proper documentation from patients, which are normally supplied by what are called third-party administrators, who are the link between or the intermediary between hospitals providing treatment and the insurance companies who finally pick up the bill for obviously whoever has got the insurance. Okay, here what happens is that because both at the level of the hospital title, location, there is no proper robust database, and added to that, you also have the problem of data entry, because the Indian names, proper names, either of hospitals or individuals or even places, are so much subject to variation that it can be mind-boggling for anyone to have one single proper standard name for any title. So added to that, you have also those who are entering data or capturing data, they create a lot of distortions. So with the result, what happens is I mentioned Insurance Information Bureau. It has a very robust database dating on health insurance claims dating from 2005 onwards. But all that huge volume of database cannot be constructively utilized for analytics, for the simple reason the data input is coming in a deficient way. This is exactly where some kind of identification of hospitals on a unique basis was felt as necessary. The comparable example is perhaps the IFSC code for banks. Today, if you want to send money from one bank to another bank, between the bank, electronically, or from one individual to another individual in another bank account, you use the simple IFSC code for the particular branch from which the money goes, and also for the particular branch which receives the money on behalf of the payee. So that kind of absence of a single code was the biggest nightmare of any analytics to be carried out. And more importantly, this was also a great detriment for fraud detection and fraud control as far as insurance claims are concerned. Because what happens is, sometimes a hospital located in X location with some Y name, suppose insurers who are paying the claims, they find out that the hospital has been colluding with either patients or doctors or with some other external persons for creating fraudulent claims for health insurance claims. Then if they, even if they are found as fraudulent, the remedial action suffers, because at a future date, the same hospital can surface with a different registration number in a different location, or sometimes even in the same location with a different name. Okay, so this is Ramchandra Hospital, can be perhaps in one location, let's say in Dholakwan, but then if there is a fraud detected in Ramchandra Hospital, they can change their name to Chandra Ram Hospital and continue in Dholakwan in the same building. So this was again a great kind of a handicap for insurance companies, because claims were fraudulent, and unfortunately in health insurance, insurers are not making money. For every 100 rupees they are receiving as premiums, they are paying more than 150 to 180 rupees as claims. And out of this 180, maybe 30 to 40 rupees is because of fraud only. So the purpose of having a national registry is to ensure the information linkage between various stakeholders in the healthcare industry. The patients, the doctors, or the hospitals which are providing the healthcare facility, and insurance companies which are perhaps picking up the bill for whatever insured population claims. So to sort out the problems which I just now highlighted, we had a role model in Aadhaar, and therefore what we tried to do was, like, Aadhaar is a unique ID for every citizen in India, proof of ID, not proof of anything else. Similarly, we wanted to make sure that each hospital which is in the insurance provision network has a unique ID. And Aadhaar was a glaring role model which we could follow. And therefore, we evolved what is called as the National Registry of Hospitals in the Insurance Provider Network, which is designated as ROHINI. ROHINI expands as Registrar Hospitals in the Insurance Network. ROHINI is basically a 13-digit unique ID allocated to each hospital which is in the insurance provider network. With this 13-digit ID, the proper name of the hospital, the exact geolocation, that is the longitude, latitude, PIN code, exact address, etc., are frozen. The important thing is, this is not done unilaterally by Insurance Information Bureau. It is the hospital which wants to participate in the insurance network, they voluntarily apply to ROHINI for an allocation of a unique ID, and a 13-digit ID is allocated to them after a particular vetting process. ROHINI, now that almost 33,000 hospitals are now enrolled in the ROHINI National Register, there are a lot of additional benefits which can come out of ROHINI. One clear example is now the Bharat Ayushman scheme, which is proposing to enroll almost 50 crore families. Now, the same hospitals which are there in the insurance network may also participate in the Bharat Ayushman. And therefore, rather than having independent codes, the ease of business can be achieved is, hospitals which have ROHINI can find it easy to find place in the Bharat Ayushman enrollment of hospitals also. Second thing is, what future can do is, if hospitals voluntarily furnish information about the facilities available, doctors available, and possibly the rates, the charges, proposed charges for various procedures, critical illness procedures, then if that can appear in Rohini, then what can happen is even patients who are seeking treatment in India from foreign countries, for example, Middle East or United States, etc., they can do an easy search on Rohini and then locate which hospital, which doctor, which date, and possibly even the level of comfort they can achieve through this. So the ultimate possibility in Rohini is to enhance medical tourism in India.